This video tutorial will take you through the ShopSite setup wizard, as well as a few basic functions in your ShopSite store to get you started. Start by choosing the language for your store and the currency for your store. Once you've selected both, click on Next. Before beginning the 9-step setup wizard, you'll need to let ShopSite know how much you want ShopSite to create. For this first option, I want to create a new store. You're letting ShopSite know that your entire website is created within ShopSite. ShopSite will be creating all of your pages, including your index page, about us page, and all of your catalog pages. For the second option, I want to add product pages to an existing site. You're letting ShopSite know that some of your pages will be created by ShopSite, and some of your pages are already created outside of ShopSite. Merchants using this option often have their index page and some content pages, such as About Us, already created, but are going to link those pages to the ShopSite catalog pages. With the third option, I want to add order buttons to my existing site. You're letting ShopSite know you've already created your entire website and will simply be copying and pasting Add to Cart buttons from ShopSite onto your pages you've created outside of ShopSite. The most common option is the first one. I want to create a new store and allowing ShopSite to create your entire website. Once you've selected which one's for you, click on Next. This page will outline what you're going to set up in the wizard. You'll set up some pages and products, select a few of your commerce settings, and select the layout and color theme. Click Next to begin the wizard. In step one, you're going to name your store. This example will be named Apple Apparel. And you could type a welcome message, such as, "Welcome to our online store." Once you've set up some text and your store name, click on Next. Here, you're going to add a product. The name and the price are required, and all the other fields are optional. You can upload an image by browsing your desktop and selecting the image that you'd like. Once the image is uploaded, close the window and select it from your pull-down menu. I'm going to have a $19.99 price and enter in a description for my product. Save changes when you're done. Let's add another product. This one I'll name T-shirt Blue. I'm going to upload an image, again browsing my desktop, finding the image that I want and uploading it. Close the window, select your image, and enter in the price. Let's add one more product just so I can see what it looks like when I'm done with the wizard. So my last product is going to be T-shirt Red. Again, I'm going to upload an image. Close the window when I'm done. Make sure my image is selected. Specify the price and a product description. Then save changes. Click Next to begin adding your categories. Let's add a category for all the products I just created. So my category name will be T-shirts. You can add text onto your page describing your T-shirt category or including some meta keywords, and then select the products to be added onto this page. Save changes when you're done. Let's add a few more categories just so we can see what it looks like when we're done with the wizard. So let's add a pants category and a shoes category. Once you've added a few categories, click on Next to go on to step four. In step four, you're setting up your tax. This is the really basic layout for tax, where you can just change it and have the shopper select it from the pull-down menu. So I live outside Utah, zero tax rate. I live in Utah, and let's do a 6% tax rate. And I live in Orem, Utah, and again, a 6% tax rate. After you've completed the setup wizard, you can go back in and set up tax to be more specific, such as tax by zip, where the customer enters in their zip code and the tax is automatically calculated. Click on Next to go on to step 5. In step 5, you're going to select the payment types you'd like to accept in your ShopSite store. The default ones are PayPal and a few credit cards. You can change the options here or add to them. And once you're done, click on Next to go on to step 6. In step 6, you're setting up your shipping. This is, again, a really basic setup for your shipping. We're going to do flat rate options, where the customer has 3 different options. Ground, let's add $3. Second day, we'll add $6. And next day, let's add $10. Once you've completed the setup wizard, you can go back in and set up more specific shipping, such as creating your own shipping by weight table, or integrating with companies such as USPS, UPS, or FedEx for real-time rates. Click on Next to go on to step 7. In step 7, you're going to set up your theme. ShopSite has many themes to choose from, so you can scroll through them and find one that you like. If you want to see what a theme looks like, click on the theme and then click on the thumbnail to get a larger view of what the theme looks like. Close the window when you're done. I'm going to select the business casual in blue. Click on Next once you've selected your theme. Now you're ready to publish your store. I'm going to be publishing 4 pages containing 3 products. Click on the Publish tab and watch as your store is generated. Click on Next once it's completed. In this step, you can click on the My Store link to open your store in a new window and see what you've created. So when I click on My Store, I have a really basic store layout, a generic top navigation, my home page with the text I added, "Welcome to our online store," and when I click on T-shirts, I'm taken to my T-shirt page where it has my 3 T-shirt products. Now we can go back in and make changes to our store. Let's start by adding a top navigation that's the same on all pages. So I'm going to go back into my store, click on the ShopSite tab to get full access to the back office. Then you're going to go into Preferences and click on Navigation. Here I'm going to set up a top navigation menu that has all of my categories listed. So click on Add and my first page will link to the home page. Now I'm going to select my home page, which is the name of my store, Apple Apparel, and click on OK, then save changes. Let's add our other 3 categories to the top. So first, pants, and select your pants page. Then let's add one for shirts, and we're going to add our T-shirt page. And our last category is shoes. So let's add one for shoes and select our shoes page. Now I'm going to add a last link that links directly to my shopping cart. So add, and this will be named View Cart. And I'm going to select the radio button to use the View Cart URL. Then save changes. Now you'll see that this menu is not enabled. So if I go back to my store, I have just this generic navigation menu enabled. To enable the one I just created, scroll to the bottom of this page, click on Configure, and then check the checkbox to enable the page menu. You'll see that you have other options. You can create a left navigation, a footer navigation, and a right navigation. But for now, I'm just creating my top navigation. Click on Save, and then publish your store. So if I go back into my page and refresh it, you'll see that now my top navigation has all of the links that I just set up. Next, you may want to add a company logo. For this, log into your back office, click on Images, and then on the bottom of this screen, you can click on Upload Image. You're going to again browse your desktop, find the image that you'd like, upload it, and now we can specify it as our company logo. So again, we're going to go to the Preferences tab, but this time, click on Layout Settings. Here you can set up many options, including your header and footer, various colors throughout your store, your page width, fonts, and many images. The first image is the company logo and URL. Check to use the company logo, and then browse your images to find the one you uploaded. Once you've selected it and specified the URL you want to use, whether it's the ShopSite homepage or your own custom page, then save changes at the bottom. After saving changes, again, publish your page, go back to your website, refresh, and see what it looks like now. You'll see I have my logo, which will link back to the homepage, and my top navigation, which I set up before. This completes the video tutorial for the ShopSite Setup Wizard.